Children, can you all see the screen importance of eating a balanced diet? Because for me it got stuck. Okay, it's showing only. Yeah, now it is. Okay, importance of eating a balanced diet. As you all know, no single food is the best source of all the nutrients. So you cannot only have a single food. It's always necessary for us to balance our food. Okay, you have to include carbohydrate, fat, protein, vitamins and minerals, then only you will be fit. Next, a balanced diet gives our body the strength to fight infections and diseases. So children, it also gives us nutrients and it helps us to fight against infections and diseases. So what are the two components important for, to fight against diseases and infections? What are the main component in food to fight against diseases and infections? Children, what are the two components responsible for fighting against infections and diseases? Or which component will protect us from diseases? Yes, Vasudev is right, vitamins and minerals. So including vitamin and mineral is also important. So first one is first point, everybody just have it in your mind. No single food is the best source of all nutrients. That's why we need to have always a balanced diet. Next, a balanced diet gives our body the strength to fight infections and diseases. Next point, together with exercise, a balanced diet helps us to maintain a healthy body weight. Eating only balanced diet is not good for you, children. You should also have physical activities. You should also do exercises. So along with exercise and balanced diet, your body will be maintained in a correct weight, or else you will be you will get obesity. Obesity means overweight. Okay, so if you're not having balanced diet, or if you are having balanced diet and if you're not doing exercise, then you will put on weight. Okay, and you will come up in the condition called obesity. Obesity means overweight. Don't write this. Next, a balanced diet gives us energy to be active throughout the day. It also boosts our concentration and performance level. Suppose if you miss or if you skip your breakfast, you cannot concentrate on the classes. So always you should provide yourself with proper balanced diet. Then only your body can function properly. Okay children, suppose if you are not having food in the morning, if you are skipping the breakfast, then you will not be active throughout the day. That's why our parents, our grandparents, our elder, all the elders will insist us to eat the breakfast. Then only you'll be very active. Then only you will be very smart also. Okay. Balanced diet is not only good for your body. Not only good for your other organs. It is also good for your brain. Okay. For mentally also it is good. Okay, you'll be very concentrated. Okay. You will not have a tiredness. So balanced diet is very important. And next point, ways of making a balanced diet. So we learned about the importance of balanced diet. Now, how can we make this balanced diet? Okay, we have few ways to make balanced diet. Children, can you all hear me? Why Janilia is putting question mark? Don't write this. Okay, now write this heading alone. Everybody write today's date and write this heading. Ways of making our diet healthy. Ways of making our diet healthy. Write this. Once you finish the heading, you are going to write your own way of eating a healthy diet. By avoiding what, you will have a healthy diet. Or by including what, you will have a healthy diet. You yourself going to write few points. I'll give you 2 minutes time for you to write it. Then I'll pick a person and I'll ask you to read the points that you have written in the notebook. So do it sincerely. point, 3 points, or 4 points. It's up to you. Instruction is ways of making our diet healthy. You will write few ways of making your diet healthy. Your own ways. How can you have a healthy diet? What all steps you can follow? What all you should not follow? Write those things. Finished? Write fast. Once you finish that, we will discuss the points that are given in the notebook. Sorry, given in the textbook. Finished? Yes, Ananjan is ready. Yes, Ananjan, come to the queue. Yes, Ananjan, what you have written? What are the ways you have written? Tell me. Read it.
By eating correct amount of balanced the diet. By not skipping meals.
Not skipping meals. Okay, very good. Yes, very good. Okay, Purvi is also waiting. Yes, Purvi, what you have written? Purvi? Okay, Shrushta is waiting. Yes, Shrushta, what you have written in the notebook? Shrushta? What
yes,
are
ma'am?
The ways? Yeah. What are the ways of making our diet healthy? What are the points you have written?
Ma'am, I can't understand what you are telling.
Look at the screen, my dear. Ways of making our diet healthy. What are the ways you can make, by what are the ways you can make your diet healthy? What are the steps you will follow? Or what are the foods you will eat? What are the foods you will avoid? What you were doing, I gave time for you to write, no? What you were doing, Rushta?
Avoid eating fried foods to reduce the amount of fats in your diet.
You are reading from the book? I asked you to write your own point. Okay, let me pick someone else. Please do it, Farida. Sorry, please do it, Rushta. Okay, write your own points. Mitran is there. Yes, Mitran. Yes, Mitran.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, Mitran.
We have to write vitamins and minerals. Mm. And we have to keep exercising. And we have to eat lots of vegetables, and we have to not eat fried foods.
Okay, superb. Okay, Mitran. So children, a few others are waiting in the queue. I will give you a chance for the next topic, okay? So now we'll discuss, everybody look at the screen. Now we will discuss the points that are given in the textbook, okay? So look, first point what they have given in the textbook is, avoid eating fried foods to reduce the amount of fat in your diet. So children, you should avoid fried items, fried food. because it has more amount of fat in it. You have to avoid fat. Why, children, we should avoid fat? Fat is also an important component of food, right? Why we need to reduce it? See, they have given reduced amount of fat. Why we need to reduce it? Fat is also the component of food, right? Any answers in the chat box? You can type it in a short way. Why? Or any keyword is fine for me. Why we need to reduce the amount of fat in the diet? So we don't become obese and fat. Yes, to reduce weight. Yes, Yarini and Lakshika, you are right. So by eating, by taking more fat, your body will gain weight. That's not good for your heart. Okay, you will be getting heart attack if you have more fat, more junk food. So first point, everybody learn the first point, reduce the amount of fat. Everybody say it, reduce the amount of fat. Next, eat a healthy and nutritious breakfast to get energy to remain active throughout the day. So first what you will do, you will reduce the fat. Next, you have to have nutritious breakfast. If you skip your breakfast, that means you are spoiling your health. You yourself, you're spoiling your health. So please eat a healthy and nutritious breakfast. Don't have Maggie in the morning. That is not a nutritious food, okay? So first point is to reduce the fat in your diet. How will you reduce the fat? By avoiding fried food. So first point, avoid fried food to reduce the amount of fat in your diet. Next, eat a healthy and nutritious breakfast to get energy to remain active throughout the day. Third one, add more fiber to your diet. Why we need to add more fiber to our diet? Because fiber will help to remove the digest food from the intestine. You all remember roughage. Roughage is fully fibers. These fibers will help to remove the waste material, digest food from the digestive tract. And this fiber also come along with it. Okay, next. Yes, in Adana, you can have dosa, chapati, but along with dosa and chapati, have vegetables also. Then only it becomes a balanced diet. So first point, everybody open your mouth and say, reduce the amount of fat. Next, have nutritious breakfast. See, I am telling only the keywords. You have to explain it. Third point, add more fiber to your diet. Fourth point, avoid adding too much salt, sugar, spices and oil to your food. Okay, this you already know. You should not have more salt, more sugar, more spices, oils to your food. Next, do not overeat. Sometimes the food may taste very well, very nice, and you will feel your stomach is full. You should not keep on dump your stomach with your favorite food. Okay, your stomach is not meant for that. Your stomach is to digest few amount of food and to give energy to you. That's it. Okay, your tongue eat nicely, it will taste the food. But who will suffer if you have overeat? Stomach only suffers. Okay, next, eat sprouts of wheat, gram, moong, bean. They promote health due to their high nutritious content. Who all will have sprouts here? Sprouts. You all know to make sprouts? Molakattinadhu in Tamil, molakattina payiru or molakattina paruppu. Someone has a doubt. Okay, Rushda, what's your doubt? Come to the queue. Wait a minute. Too much of tomato is bad only. Too much of anything is good for nothing. Rushda, come. Yes, Rushda is waiting. Yes, Rushda, what's your doubt? Yes, ma.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Am I audible? Ma'am, yes. If in the fat, chocolate and carbohydrates are also included. If we take like paratha, butter, then it can also cause us overweight and diet, no?
Yes, if you have more paratha, more butter, that is not good for you. Not at all good. And that too, parathas are made up of maida. Maida is not good for our health. Okay. So, can you say from the beginning first, avoid fat or reduce fat amount in the food. And next point, have nutritious breakfast. Third point, even I am trying to recall the points. You all try it along with me. Third point, what did we see after having nutritious food? Third point, yes, I will send the PPT. Yes, Dheeraj, you are right. Add fiber in your food. Okay, have fiber. Okay. Fourth point, avoid adding too much salt, sugar, spices and oil to your food. Fifth point, do not overeat. Sixth point, eat sprouts. And I am going to give you an activity for this week. I want you to prepare a sprout. I will also share a video how to make a sprout and have it. Okay? I will share a video in Google Classroom. I want you to do it. Take a picture of you eating it. Take a picture of you eating the sprouts and you will send it to me. Understood? Take a picture of you eating sprouts and you will send it to me. So these are the 6 points of to know the importance of, sorry, to know the ways of having a healthy food. I hope you remember all the 6 points, and we have 3 more points. Eat fermented food like idli, dosa, and drink fermented drinks like lassi, yogurt, and juices regularly. They help in digestion and protect our body from diseases. What we mean by fermented? Fermented. No, you know, Aradhana, you can send it in Google Classroom itself. I will send all the homeworks in Google Classroom only. Just normal, your doubts and normal chat, something, you can do it in WhatsApp. All other official school information will be posted in Google Classroom only. Now tell me, what is fermented? Furnished. No. Fermented means in Tamil, pulikke vaikirudhu. Okay, how they'll prepare a dosa? How they prepare idli, how they prepare lassi, how they prepare curd. They'll make them, they'll take the milk, they'll put 2 drops of curd and they will leave for 1 day, right? Yeah, overnight or 1 day. Same happens for idli and dosa. They'll prepare that dosa flour and they'll keep it for a day so that it gets fermented. In Tamil, pulikke vaikirudhu, okay? This will help in help to promote our digestion. That's why in Tamil Nadu, okay, we will, or in India, we used to have curd after having sambar rice or anything. Okay, along with biryani also, we have curd and onion, because this curd will promote digestion. And during our lunch time, at the end, we will have small amount of rice and we will eat that rice with curd. Why they are doing it? Because this will improve our digestion. Replace aerated drinks. What we mean by aerated drinks? Can anyone type in the chat box aerated drinks? Can anyone give me the example for this drink? Fanta. Okay, yes, was they fresh U8D. Okay, so aerated water is nothing but carbohydrated water. It will have more gas. Soda, Coke, Sprite, 7-Up, Fanta, all has gas in it. All these are aerated drinks. You have to replace those aerated drinks with fresh water, fresh juice, lime water, coconut water. For example, if you are going to have you are going to buy a Bavanta or you are going to buy some soda. Instead of that, you can have fresh juice. Okay, fresh juice and lime water, coconut water. You have to replace that because these aerated drinks are not good for our health. Next, eat fruits, salads, nuts. Aravind has asked some doubt. Using sprouts means, Paris, look at the picture here. Can you look at the picture for us? We have this gram, wheat, moong, bean with one white color tail. Paris, can you see that? Yes, Arvind, you are right. We'll use bacteria to using bacteria to eat yeast. Okay. Lemonade is good. Nitrite is good, right, ma'am? Yes, lemonade is good. And as far as you saw, okay, doubt is clear. So children, we learnt about 9 points. 9 points or 9 ways of making a healthy diet. So please, you have to follow this. Instead of having the sodas, Fantas, you ask for a coconut water or fruit juice. Okay, instead of just having chapati, puri, idli, dosa for breakfast, at least try sprouts, having sprouts. I will share a video of making it. It's very easy. Okay, you can also try, shoot a video. You can post it in Google Classroom also. Okay, you have to post it in Google Classroom only. Next comes junk food. Okay, you all love it, right? We all love it. But unfortunately, this junk food is rich of carbohydrates, sugar and salt only. They don't have proteins and vitamins. So having more junk food is not good for us. Even though it is very delicious, we should not have it more. Okay, now everybody write the heading junk food and write this first paragraph. Look at the screen and write the first paragraph. Right first, I'll explain you what junk food is. I hope you finished writing this. Mitran has a doubt. Children, please write the first para alone. What is junk food? Yes, Mitran, where are you? Yes, Mitran, what's your doubt?
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, Mitran.
Instead of lassi, we can also drink apple carrot beetroot juice, no, ma'am?
Yes, you can have it. Yes, you can have it. You can have it. Why I especially mentioned this fermented juices? These fermented items will promote your digestion. Okay.
Okay.
It helps your digestion. That's why we will always add curd in our food. Okay. After having sambar rice or any rice, we will have curd.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, we'll take small amount of rice and we will eat that with curd. Why we are doing it? Why we have this practice of including curd in our food? Because this curd is a fermented drink, okay, fermented liquid item which promote our digestion. So you can have ABC juice. That's also good. Okay, it will give you proteins. Okay, sorry, it will give you vitamins and minerals. But You should include yogurt or curd in your food. And you have to have idli, dosa. All these are fermented food which promotes your digestion. It's good for digestion.
And ma'am, I am eating sprouts today as snacks.
Okay, very good.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye.
Yes. Children, finish writing this. When will school reopen? Yes, Vaishali, soon. Soon our school will reopen. Okay, don't worry. Finish writing this, children. Just write the first one. first paragraph. Okay, so what is junk food? This junk food word is very familiar to us, right? Always our parents, teachers, okay, elders will advise us not to have junk food. But this junk food tastes delicious, yes? It tastes very well, okay, very good. But people advise us not to have the junk food because junk food has no nutritious value. It has only fat. See, read the explanation of junk food. Junk food is any food that contains high amount of sugar, starch and fat with low amount of other nutrients. So starch, sugar you all know, fat you all know. This starch is a new word. What is starch, children? Starch. Anyone knows? Starch is a substance of food that gives you energy. That's it. It's like carbohydrate. Okay, starch is a food substance in the food which gives energy. Okay, so junk food has only fat. So eating too much of junk food is not good. Okay, if you have more junk food, what happens to your body? What will happen to you? What will happen if you have more fat? We already discussed, right? If you have, yeah, obesity. Very good. You will gain more weight and this junk food, this fat will get accumulated in the blood vessel. It will block the blood flow. Okay, if the blood flow is blocked, what happens? Your heart cannot work. Your heart cannot pump. You will get BP, blood pressure. Okay, your heart cannot function properly. If your heart is not functioning properly or not functioning, what happens? It's not good for you. You will get heart attack, right? So that's why our elders are advising us not to have junk food because it doesn't have any other nutritious value, only fat, full of fat. That's it. Okay, these food items may be delicious, but they do not provide any nutritional benefits. So next class, we will learn about the effects of junk food and we will learn about the disease related to our food habits. Okay, children. So ma'am will be posting you a Google form in Google Classroom, Google form link in the Google Classroom. I want you all to do that. So what did we learn in today's class? We learned about the importance of balanced diet. We learned about the ways of making our diet healthy and we learned about junk food. What is junk food? Next class, we will learn about the adverse effects of junk food and diseases related to food habits and lifestyle. Okay, thank you. You can leave now.